Hi guys, this is Dr. Farjana. Hope you guys are doing amazing. All right, today I'm going to talk about what can you do when you're stuck on a decision. What can you do when you're stuck on a decision, okay? I want you to ask yourself, number one, what is the right thing to do? Number two, I want you to ask yourself, what makes the most sense? Number three, I want you to ask yourself, which decision is a little better? So if you're stuck between two, ask yourself, which decision is a little bit better, right? And last, this is extremely important, when you don't know what to do, just take some quiet time, right? Just listen to the stillness, listen to the silence around you. Just take some time away from the family and just be in like nature, connect with God, maybe read the holy book, and the answer will come to you. Right? So you have to be in quietude. Like you have to be in quiet space. All right, guys. Another technique that's extremely important is noticing the space around you, right? Like just spaces around the environment. When you notice spaces, it helps you pause, right? It helps from that repetitive thinking, right? That rush thinking. So noticing those spaces as you're walking, right? And when I mean spaces, I'm talking about like, let's say a space from one car to another car. Just noticing the space from one tree to another tree, right? Like noticing those gaps. As you notice more of those gaps, right? More gaps and spaces are created between your thought processes, right? So you're able to just breathe in and breathe out, right? And decisions will come to you. All right, guys, hope this was helpful. Take care. Hi, guys, this is Dr. Farjana. Hope you guys are doing well. Hope you guys are doing well. Today, I want to talk about how successful people make decisions. Successful people take their time to make decisions, right? They weigh out the pros and the cons. Their decisions are not impulsive and they're not reckless, right? So you want to ask yourself, is this decision impulsive? Is this decision reckless? Right? They need to be well thought out. You want to make sure those decisions are well thought out. And sometimes, if you see a person not making any decision at all, right? And that's okay too. That doesn't mean that they're being irresponsible, right? They're giving you some time and space, right? When you don't know what to do, right? When you're just like, I do not know what to do right now, right? Sometimes quiet time, right? Being in quiet space helps make those decisions, right? Because you're getting connected to your inner self. You're taking all the toxins out. And then hence, the right decisions will come to you, right? You have to listen to the universe. You have to listen for God to answer your prayers, right? The decision will come to you, right? But remember, successful people take their time. Decisions are never impulsive and they're never reckless. Yes, yes, sometimes you take risks, but that's different, right? Because you can still take risks, right? That are well thought out risks. Okay, guys? All right. Hope this was helpful. Take care. You got this. Hi, good morning, guys. This is Dr. Farjana. Hope you guys are doing amazing. Today, I'm going to talk about how to be decisive. Say no, absolutely not, right, to indecisiveness. Say no, absolutely not to indecisiveness, right? Understand that conflict in decision-making or oscillating between decisions brings chaos to you, right? It brings chaos in your mind and body. It puts you back basically in a flight and fight situation, right? Be extremely mindful of this state, right? And recognize indecisiveness at its core. As soon as it happens, start recognize it, right? You might have to use this mantra to say to yourself, I trust myself. I trust my decisions and move on, right? So notice the indecisiveness and then use this mantra. Also, how to move forward and stick to it with a decision. Many times we have been trained to be unsure of ourselves, right? We might have, maybe this is some societal programming, some cultural programming, right? Even just familial family programming, right? we have to make a, we make a decision and then we stay in a regret phase, right? Have you, a lot of you have done that. I've done this in the past, right? Like I made a decision and then I'm like, wait a second, right? So I'm going to just share some simple techniques that you can use, right? I mentioned one already. Use the mantra, I trust myself, I trust my decisions. Number two, let time pass, right? When you were going to accomplish this task. So let's say you had a plan to, you know, get this licensure exam done, right? And now you said, I'm done with it. I'm not doing it anymore, right? So be decisive. And let's say you take this exam every 3 months. Let the time pass. As the time passes, your body and mind will, get used to it, acclimate, right? It'll get used to it. Number three, when you see yourself ruminating and contemplating again, say, I've already made my decision. I can revisit this later if I want. I'll say that again. I've already made my decision. I can revisit this later if I want, right? So realize where you focus your energy is crucial. Do not place it on lack, particularly regretting decisions, right, guys? Like, think about it. Like, your energy is precious. So don't waste it, right, on lack thinking, lack states, right? When you are regretting a decision, you're in that lack state again. Like, oh no, I could have, right? Also, another way you don't want to focus on lack thinking, right, is other people's lack, right? So don't focus on their lack either. And that can be, I'm going to definitely speak about that on another segment. Okay, guys, so hope this was helpful. Okay, guys, be decisive. Make a decision and go with it. And notice when you get into this indecisive state and say, no, absolutely not. I'm not doing it, right? Because it's going to take you away from the present moment, your current abundance. It will take you away from that. And you don't want to be in that place. All right, guys, I hope this is helpful. Okay, take care of yourself. Hi guys, this is Dr. Farjana. Hope you guys are doing well. Today I'm going to talk about decision making, right? When you have codependent tendencies, sometimes it's hard for you to think for yourself, right? When making decisions. What you want to do in a group event, right? Or how do you want to spend your weekends when you're with your family? I will share a simple technique that will help you consider your needs as well. It's very simple, okay? I want you to ask yourself, does this work for me when you're making the decisions? Does this also work for me when you're making the decision, right? So this can occur during weekend plannings, right? Evening plans when you're going out with your family or friends. Biological family, extended family, you always have to ask yourself, does this work for me? You are not obligated to do anything. You are not obligated to do anything, right? If it's at the expense of your mental and physical well-being. Okay, guys? So always prioritize this. Okay, and I know you might be a mother in the family or a sister or whatever your role is, a father. We always also have to ask yourself, does this work for me? Okay, so you don't end up just catering towards everyone else and then you're exhausted by Sunday night and you're like, wait a second, you know, I think I did too much, right? So again, simple technique, does this work for me? Okay, take care, guys.